Hey everybody, welcome back to Star Wars The Old Republic. This is Yuck. Back playing Jedi Consular class. So, I don't know what happened last time, but one thing's for sure, my game crashed. And it actually hasn't been a while. Well, it actually has been a while since I actually played Star Wars. I played this on this account. It's been a while since I've recorded the last few series. The last few episodes. I'm messing things up today. But I'm back. I'm back. Yeah. Well, no, really. Dur is yuck. You're stupid. Anyways. So if you haven't noticed anything different with the microphone quality or anything, it's because I have my original microphone back, which I had before I even started uploading YouTube videos. Well, I had it when I started uploading YouTube videos, but I don't think I have those videos anymore because I didn't like them. As some of you may know, I don't even know if I've actually said that, but I did have a lot of YouTube videos up before, but I deleted them because I didn't really like the way they turned out because I felt they were kind of stupid, or like the way that I commentated it back way back when was kind of stupid anyways. So there's that. So yeah, I may not have this microphone for a while because the reason why I didn't have it for a long time is because I had lended it to a friend, and his name, you may know him or you may not know him, but his YouTube account is Jared113. I will probably link him in the description down below, but that is irrelevant. Let's go talk to this guy.
You're too late, Jedi. Like all the other times. The Flesh Raiders already came. They already took their victims. My father knew these mountains. He helped guide the patrols when he could. But when the Flesh Raiders appeared, he never made it home. He wasn't young, but he deserves better than to be ripped apart. Show compassion, Jedi. Find him, and kill any raiders who'd stop you.
I'd prefer to negotiate, if possible. But I will find your father.
You can't talk to Flesh Raiders, Jedi. They don't think like people. They're only interested in blood. If you find him, if he's hurt or confused, you'll know him by his golden promise ring. He wouldn't part with it. Not until death.
So, we gotta go find this guy's father anyways. Also, I'm a little bit sick right now. Just a little bit. Well, I have been sick and I'm not that sick anymore, but I still have, like, a little sniffly cold, and my voice is, like, my throat is, like, a tiny bit dry. It's not dry to the point where I can't talk, like it used to be. Just a second. Wait, let's talk to this guy.
Break out another cask, or three. The festival only comes once a year. Our stores can take it.
Just as well. We have an uninvited guest.
I see. Festival of Awakening, Jedi. You're not welcome here.
I apologize for interrupting. Master Yuan Par asks if you've seen a Jedi holoprojector.
Huh. If Yuan Par is asking, guess we could try and remember.
A holoprojector. Yeah, I know what you mean. Naylan found one. Naylan Rollick. Maybe you heard of him?
I haven't. It sounds like he has a reputation.
Naylan Rollick. Our dueling champion for 9 years straight. He once rescued an entire scouting party from Flesh Raiders single-handed. He planned our defenses. Protects us when we go foraging. Without him, we wouldn't even be having the festival. And no, I am not telling you where he is. Naylan earns his peace and quiet.
That hologram's data isn't safe. Naylan should be warned. Or do you want to risk something happening to him?
Naylan can take care of himself.
Against Flesh Raiders, sure. But some of that Jedi tech is weird.
Okay, fine. Naylan went into the Flesh Raiders territory. He's probably still there. He's been gone a while.
I thought this was a special day. Shouldn't he be here, celebrating?
Naylan just likes to be alone these days, and festivals aren't really his thing.
Though last year, He did the Waker's Dance for the rest of us.
I think Naylan's got a camp out there. If you see him, tell him to be back for the feast.
Alright. Sounds pretty good. There's a lot of little quest things around here. Good to get a little bit more XP. Actually, we kind of need these extra quests.
For a humble servant of the matriarch. I promise, your other dealings will wait. My name is Vedariot Aeon. I minister to the bodies and spirits of the villagers, and I have a request. I speak of the Flesh Raiders. Of late, we've seen them growing stronger, and I know why.
And the reason why I need them is because of how the XP works. As a non-subscriber, as just a free-to-play player, you really don't gain as much XP, and therefore you are really not, like, on the same level as the story really wants you to be. So you're always going to be underleveled, at least for, like, the later levels, and it becomes, like, harder to keep up with them. That works because, like, if you are subscribed, then you gain bonus experience, and they didn't want the subscribers to be, like, over-experienced all the time, so they tried to make it, like, just barely over enough. If that makes any sense, it probably doesn't, because I'm really bad at explaining things.
You have my attention. The Flesh Raiders have been experimenting, concocting an elixir that makes them ravenous. The ones who drink it go mad. Their lips froth, and they pounce like starving animals. It's black medicine, primitive and evil.
How could Flesh Raiders learn to do something like that?
I have no idea. Such wickedness is beyond our comprehension. We lack the numbers to attack the Flesh Raiders directly, and not even the Jedi could wipe the monsters from this world. But with our warriors' help, the Jedi could reach the Flesh Raider caves and destroy their vats of elixir.
Then I will make it happen.
Thank you for this. Odemus Mare knows where the vats are hidden. He is our guard captain. Talk to him to learn the Raiders' secrets.
More young Jedi in Kalikori, I see. I am Yulaf Fahn, Master of Rituals. I welcome you. You wish to participate in the ceremony, I presume? You understand the dangers?
There's no doubt about it.
Good. Together we'll bridge the gap between Pilgrim and Jedi. Many of your brethren, your Padawans, come to Kalikori to perform our rite of passage. Those who endure the ceremony are awarded an audience with Kolovish to receive her wisdom and her gifts.
Who's Kolovish? What's the ceremony all about?
Kolovish lives in the mountains above. Once our leader, now she is our guide and protector. To complete the ceremony, you must walk 1,000 steps to her home. You must carry a burning brand and light the signals along the path. You must protect the flame from beasts and flesh raiders. This will prove your worth. If you wish, I will ignite the brand. It burns only a short while. But if you are deserving, it will be enough.
I am ready to carry the flame.
Then go, and light each of the signal fires along the mountain path. When you reach the end, you will find Kolovish.
As I think I've noticed before, as I think I've noted before, I have done most of these quests already. But once we get up to, I think, the last boss on Coruscant, then it'll be all new to me. Of course, I do have a main account. It is a Jedi Knight, or Jedi Guardian to be exact, which I have done up to the end of Tatooine, so of course I'll know the where everything is on those planets, and I'll have explored all that before. But I really won't have really want to play the Consular storyline, because the Consular and Warrior storylines are both, like, very different. So I'll know the area and everything, all the side quests and all that, but I won't really have played the main storyline. After about Alderaan, I think, if I haven't played on my main account since the last time I played, then it'll all be right. Actually, I've only done part of Alderaan. That's been a place where I've been grinding for quite a while, because I was underleveled on that account, so I had to, like, grind a really long time. But yeah, After I'm in that general area, I'm not sure if it's like a thing, because like I really don't know what I'm doing with this series, like whether I want it to be like an informative like walkthrough or just like a first experience, which of course it will be after I'm done Alderaan. Getting a lot of stuff that I can't use, which kind of sucks. So as of recent, I've actually been like searching for more games to play. One of the games that I came across is World of Warcraft, which is, like, obviously everybody in gaming, or everybody in general, should know what World of Warcraft is. And I don't know if that's going to be the next game, like, I record or anything. Because I played it a lot, like, multiplayer with one of my friends. Whom I mentioned earlier. Didn't record that. But I don't know if I will record it. In general. I might get him to record it with me, might not, I don't know. I might do it solo, of course. Dang, man. I really want to grab the cards. This is actually screwing me up a lot. The fact that there's so much lag right here. Like, frame drops and all that. Luckily, it's not too bad, and I can still play the game. It might not be good for quality, but hey, this is something else. Yeah, I'm sniffing all over the place. Please. Please, don't. Don't. Why not rock? I want to rock. Chest up here. This actually might give me something good, or it might give me crap. Probably gonna give me... Oh, that wasn't at all needed. Well, I won't complain. It's a few more credits to add to my account, my bank account, which I don't have, because... Oh my gosh, what is happening? Is it lagging out again? Okay, there we go. It's good. What just happened? Right. Oh boy. This is not good. I might have to turn down my graphics a little bit. As we saw last time, that won't work while I'm recording. Yeah, it's freezing a lot. Hold on just a second, I'll turn off the recording for a little bit. I really hate to show such low quality on my videos, but I don't really have a choice. At least, well, that didn't work at all. At least it's less. I don't really have a choice whether I have low graphics or high graphics or not. My computer works perfectly fine with World of Warcraft, which is actually a good thing. So, like, more really think about it, it seems like a really good way to really do this kind of recording thing. Because, yeah, like, World of Warcraft and Minecraft, two pretty good games, two pretty popular games too. I know, like, doing either of those games, like, I wouldn't really get that many views, because, like, obviously I'm not that many views at all, and everybody would be preoccupied with other people's views, with other people's videos. And said people are way more famous and well-known.